because all the rest of this verse, you've already had these words, so. Let's see. So we're going to start here. So who has the first one? Josh?
Yes. Legal God.
Legal God. Yes. Legal God. Everyone say Legal God.
Legal God.
Right here. Legal God. Legal God. Legal God. Again. Legal God. Thank you.
Amen. The break. Demo. A. Rich. Break. Demo. A. Rich.
Let's see how it all goes. Legal God. Can everybody read that? It means green. Green. Everyone say Legal God.
Legal God.
Means green.
Green.
Okay, who has the next one? Charity. Wait. I'm going to make people suffer. Richard. No cheating. So what is it?
Shell.
Shell. Everyone say shell.
Shell.
Okay. Shell. Can you give it to me?
Shell.
Shell.
Then. E. Love it.
Okay, so this is shell. Now, I've got to tell you something about this word. Shell is actually modern Hebrew.
Oh.
That's a guy's name, isn't it? Shell?
Shell, no.
No. Shell, so is that?
It is modern Hebrew. You will not actually find this word in the Torah scroll. And there's a reason for that, but you do find it in the brachot. For example, the woman's bracha over the lighting of the candles. Ner shel Shabbat. Ner, candle, shel Shabbat. Okay? So, this word is the preposition, is a preposition. And in Hebrew, we've kind of discussed this somewhat before. In Hebrew, prepositions and things like that, one Hebrew word can mean several English prepositions, all right? So this is the preposition of, from, pertaining to, made from, or made of. So when we say ner shel Shabbat, ner meaning candle, Shabbat, you know. So put the shel in there, meaning what? Ner, candle, of Shabbat. Okay, or shel from, or pertaining to. Okay, so it's that kind of idea. Okay, now, in Biblical Hebrew, remember that of and to are the same, okay, and it's the lamed. When you have a lamed like this, that's a prefix to a word. You have the lamed looking like that, and at the beginning, the prefix to a word. Kind of crooked lamed here. This of, this means to or of. So this is the way you would see it in the Torah scroll. Now the reason, and remember that there, also remember that when you have two nouns side by side, what about the preposition there? You have a noun and you have a noun side by side. There is no of, it's understood, okay? So in English, the of would be understood. That's the other problem, is that the preposition in biblical Hebrew, the preposition many times is understood in English, saying that it's not written into the Hebrew, okay? So when you have these people coming from all over the world, they're speaking all these different kinds of languages and all of these kinds, that kind of thing taking place, and you're trying to reinstitute Hebrew, one of the things that you find is that you have to make up new words. And most of the European languages have the preposition of, so, or from. So what are you going to do? You're trying to teach Hebrew in a quick and systematic way to these people coming to Israel and whatever, and you don't have a preposition of. You just have these nouns side by side, right? And it's understood. So how do you get the concept across? So the way you get the concept across is you just make up a word for of, and that's what shav is. Okay, so that's why I'm telling you that this is a modern Hebrew. Because I'm using a modern Hebrew translation of Matthew, so the shell is there. Okay? Everybody got it? Okay, next one, who's got it? Okay, Richard? I'll learn you to rely on your wife.
Hardal.
Hardal. Okay, so it's ch. Hardal. Everyone? Hardal. Everyone? Hardal. Again? Hardal. Okay? So, Hardal. Give it to me.
Kav. A.
What? What's this one?
I don't know, Terry, you gave me wrong answers.
Well, quit depending on Terry. This is letters.
Oh, that's it. It's a K.
Okay.
Is he giving me wrong
answers? K? What's this one?
A.
Raish.
No, don't give it to him. Needs to learn.
Break.
Dalit. And another A. And Lamed.
Okay. So. Chardal. Chardal, and chardal means
mustard.
Google Translate works for us, right?
Yes. Not the mustard seed, just mustard.
Well, look at what you have over here.
Green.
Okay, who's got it? Charity. Go. Emilio, Charity, did you go yet?
Yes.
Yeah, well, okay, but I went to the
twice. Twice. Emilio, you have it? In your mouthful? Mm-hmm. Swallow first, chew it.
Everybody tonight so far.
See, I pick on the people who are chewing, not good. No.
Yes, you got it.
Okay, Charity, go ahead.
Okay.
Kaha.
Say it again.
Kaha.
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 A little bit better. Close enough.
Kaha.
Just trying to be.
No cussing in here. Kaha. Alright. Everyone say kaha.
Kaha.
Say it again. Kaha.
Kaha.
Give it to me. What's the name of the letter?
Kuf.
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 Kaha. And kaha means if you take grass, seeds, grain. Kaha. So, take these, and put them here. One more time. You only have four words tonight because all the other words in this sentence you've already had. All the other words in this verse you've already had. So you have four newer words, so you have to find the new words and put them in place. Okay, so let's start here. Who's got it? Sure, just got a little thing done. This is your night, girl. What do you
have?
So sound it out.
Sen.
The short end. So Vayasen. Everyone?
Vayasen.
Say it. Vayasen. Say it again. Vayasen. Remember that the dot in the yud is the dagesh, telling you that it's a vowel. Okay? So Vayasen. So who remembers what Vayasen was?
Shall.
Okay, so you know this right
Liz.
Here? We're going to talk about this tonight. Good. We're going to talk about this. What is this right here?
And.
And. What?
Place.
Okay. And placed.
What?
Vayasem, and placed. Okay, who's got the next one? Richard. Not exactly. So sign it out right here. Up here with me. Lee. So this is all gonna be one. This is all gonna be one syllable. Because you have this right here. So what? Leaf. This is together. Okay, so what is leaf naked? You've already had this word?
Before them, or them before.
Very good. No? You had it right the first time?
Before them.
Okay, so this is the suffix. Leaf name means before. Remember panim, we talked about panim, which is the root of leaf name, panim, which means face.
Face.
So what you have is to face, face to face. Okay, so before. Him This was a word that you had several weeks ago, ken, meaning?
Bim.
So this is a suffix. You have this, you have these words almost exactly in this order. Okay? So here we go, ready? Again? What is it?
And place before them.
Okay, so in Hebrew, Vayasem livnehem. Vayasem livnehem. Vayasem livnehem. Vayasem livnehem. Mashal, very good. Everyone say mashal.
Mashal.
We use mashal quite a bit, even in the Shabbat teachings. We're using the term mashal. Okay, in the Judaism 101 class, we're using the term mashal. Give it to me. No, you don't have to give it to me. Mashal means what?
Parable.
Yes. So give it to me. English.
And place before them parable.
Okay, now we're going to talk about this tonight. Because what? Understood. Okay, indefinite article. There is no indefinite article in Hebrew, so it's understood. So do it again.
And place before them parable.
Okay, Hebrew. Vayasem, everyone?
Vayasem,
livnehem, mashal. Again. See? Cool, you're reading Hebrew. It's like that. Vayasem, livnehem, mashal. Vayasem, livnehem, mashal. Again. Vayasem, livnehem, mashal. And place before them a parable. Okay, let's go to the next one. Josh?
Acher.
Acher. Everyone?
Acher.
Acher. And Acher is?
Another.
Very good. So everyone say acher.
Acher.
Let's do English, ready? And place before them parable another. Again. And place before them parable another. Hebrew. Vayasem livnehem mashal acher. Again. Vayasem livnehem mashal acher. Again. Vayasem livnehem mashal acher. Again, one more time, everybody. Vayasem livnehem mashal acher. Okay? And place before them parable another. Okay? This one also you've already had. And you will see this word very, very frequently in Torah, throughout the scriptures.
Vayomer.
Close. Look at your vows.
Vayomer.
Vayomer. Everyone. Vayomer. Say it.
Vayomer.
Now look at your yud here. Okay. So it's not vayi. It's vayo. Okay. The aleph is silent. Vayo. So the yud is taking on the o sound. The aleph is simply assisting the o. Are you with me?
Yes.
Okay. So va yo me, va yo va yo ma, va yo ma, va yo ma. Everyone, va yo ma. Again, va yo ma, va yo ma. So va is.
Said.
Said.
Remind
me of. Say it again.
Say.
Say. To say.
Say.
So. And.
same.
What is that? Wait, wait.
The idea is to get the root down, and then you try to figure out the conjugation of it, okay? By its context. You'll learn that as you go along. You'll learn the different terms and conjugations and such as that. All right? You already have this one. You already know this one. Malchut. Everyone?
Malchut.
Which is kingdom. So, let's go back to the beginning. Ready?
And place before them a parable of another and say kingdom.
Again.
And place before them parable of another and say kingdom.
Again. And place before them parable of another and say kingdom. Hebrew.
Vayaser lifnehem mashal acher. Vayomer Malchut.
Again. Vayomer, yes. Excuse me. Because Vayomer, the difference is this, Vayomer. Vayomer is past tense, he said. Okay, so this is present tense, perfect participle. Saying. Alright, say it again, ready? Vayaser. Lifnehem mashal acher vayomer malchut. Again. Vayaser lifnehem mashal acher vayomer malchut. Okay, next one you already know. Hashamayim, which is?
Heaven. Not heaven.
It would actually, because if you remember
the kingdom, the
definite article is on the second noun, but it, in English it would go here. Okay. Now this is the two nouns side by side, which is what?
Of in the middle is
understood.
Understood.
Okay. So Hashemayim. So let's do it in English. Ready? And place before them parable another and say kingdom heaven. No of, because the of's not there in the Hebrew, it's understood in English, but I want you to get used to the sound of not having it there. Alright? Again. And place before them parable another and say kingdom heaven. Again. And place before them parable another. And saying, kingdom heaven. Hebrew. Vayaser lifnehem mashal acher. Vayomer malchut hashamayim. Again. Vayaser lifnehem mashal acher. Vayomer malchut hashamayim. One more time. Vayaser lifnehem mashal acher vayomer malchut hashamayim. Next word.
Doma.
Doma, very good. And doma means?
Similar.
Similar. This is where you get is like. Okay, so the kingdom of, as you know, he says, Yeshua uses this term frequently. The kingdom of heaven is like unto, da-da-da-da, he goes on in parallel, the Mashiach. Okay, so doma is that word, is like unto. Okay, so similar. So is there ready? Everyone say doma.
Doma.
Again, doma.
Doma.
English, and place before them parable another, as saying kingdom heaven similar. Okay? So kingdom of is understood, heaven here is understood. There is no verb to be in Hebrew. So So it would say and place before them a parable, another, and saying kingdom of heaven is similar, is the way it would read in English. Okay, because these words in parentheses are understood, they're not in the Hebrew. They do not occur in the Hebrew. So let's do it again. And place before them parable, another, and saying kingdom heaven similar. Again. And place before them parable another, and say kingdom heaven is similar. Hebrew. Vayaser bifnehem mashal acher vayomar malchut hashamayim domar. Again, very good. Vayaser bifnehem mashal acher vayomar malchut hashamayim domar. Again. Vayaser bifnehem mashal acher vayomar malchut hashamayim domar. All right, now the new words. Here we go. So this one is what?
Legagar.
Everyone. Legagar. 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 Le. Ready? Legagar. Again. Legagar. Again. Legagar. And legagar is
green.
English. And place before them parable another, and say kingdom heaven similar great. A great is understood. Okay. No indefinite article. So it is understood. Alright, again. And place before them parable another, and say kingdom heaven similar great. Hebrew. Vayaser bifnehem mashal acher vayomar malchut hashamayim domar legagar. Again. Vayaser bifnehem
mashal
acher vayomar vayomar malchut hashamayim domar legagar. Again. Vayaser bifnehem mashal acher vayomar malchut hashamayim domar legagar. Next one. Okay, and you have a dash here, so it's telling you yes, they're connected, but they're not
They're connected in the middle.
So, shell is what?
Just or from, pertaining to.
Okay. And what?
Chardal. Mustard.
Chardal, which is mustard. Everyone. Chardal. Chardal.
Chardal.
Chardal. Okay, English, and place before them parable another, and say kingdom heaven similar grain of mustard. Again, and place before them parable another, and say kingdom heaven similar grain of mustard. Now, you see right here, the shell is missing. Here you say it, see it in place. Here you have now, and here you have now. Okay? Why? I don't know. That's the way this guy did it. These translators. Like I said, you will not see this word in the Torah scroll. This will not be in the Torah scroll, but it does occur in the blessings, in the Rahom. Okay, Hebrew. Vayaser lifnehem mashal acher vayomar malchut hashamayim domar legagar של חרדל.
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 כן.
Khardal. Khardal.
Use your Listerine, gargle a little bit. Khardal. That gave you natural Listerine. Alright. Here you go, ready? Vayasin livnehem mashal ache vayomad mahut hashamayim doma lekandar Shechardal again. Vayasim livnehem mashal acher vayomar makut hashamayim doma lekandar Shechardal. Okay, question for you. Question for you. Why do we have a modern word in a Hebrew text from the scriptures?
Maybe to make it easier to understand? I don't know. Yeah.
But remember, where is this scripture taken from? Matiyahu, Matthew. What do we know about the Brit Chadashah and what do we know about Matiyahu?
He was a tax collector.
But what do we know about the scripture? Of the Brit Chadashah,
the most recent we have is Greek.
Correct. The majority of the Brit Chadashah is written in Greek, and that's the text that we rely on. Now they do have it in Aramaic, Petishah, but Matiyahu, and they have found recently a Hebrew. But up until recently, all we really had was the Greek. So what these people do to put the Brit Chadashah into Hebrew is they have to translate back to the Hebrew from the Greek. So since this is a more recent, I'm not saying it's modern as in modern modern, but it is modern
compared to
back then. All right. So where this word shel does not have appeared 2,000 years ago, now we have it. So the translators stick it in there. Okay, because to the modern Hebrew ear, Jewish Israeli ear, it makes more sense this way. And that's what I was trying to say. If you have these people from all over the world learning Hebrew, and you don't have this prepositional form that appears in all the other languages but not in Hebrew, then it makes sense for them to make a word so that it would be like you're trying to explain TV if you don't have the word television in the language. So how do you explain television if you don't have the word television? You make up a word, which, by the way, is what they did in Hebrew. I don't know what the word is, but there was no word in biblical Hebrew for television. So in modern Hebrew, they made up a word for television. By the way, a lot of times they will borrow from other languages and give it a Israeli accent. Okay. So let's do it again. Ready? Vayasir livnehem mashal acher vayomar. Sorry, my fault. Vayomar makut hashamayim doma legadar shel chazal. Okay, next.
Asher.
Which means? So, and place before them parable another, and saying, kingdom heaven similar grain of mustard to do. More here because it's his. Yeah, because we're going to be talking in past tense here. Okay, so it's something that is already done. He done did this. Okay, ready? And place before them parable another, and saying, Kingdom, heaven, similar, grain of mustard to do.
Hebrew.
Vayasev livnehem mashal acher vayomar malchut hashamayim doma ledadar sher chagal asher.
This would be to do, this would be which he did, which did.
Okay, I mean, understand this verse this way. Ready? Here we go. Vayasin livnehem mashal acher vayomar malchut hashamayim domar legadar sher chagal asher. Now, I want you to start giving it emphasis like you would in English, okay? You, in English, you don't talk, well, unless you're trying to draw a teacher. Alright? You don't talk straight. You have emphasis on syllables and on words, okay? So now you're understanding what these words are saying, so give it the emphasis that belongs on that word since you know what it's saying. So let's do it. Ready? Vayasev livnehem mashal acher vayomar malchut hashamayim דובר לגרע שר חרדר אשר. Next one.
לחכו.
Everyone. לחכו. Again. It's a Q sound. לחכו. לחכו. Everyone. לחכו. Again. לחכו. Again. Now this is the last of your vocabulary for tonight. Okay? So this was new. Okay. This was new, and this one was new. Okay? So what do you know about this one?
To take or to grasp.
Okay. Take or grasp.
Root word.
What do you know about the
lame? Two or of.
Two or of.
And the root word is.
Which is
to take
or grasp.
Okay.
And then you have the O. And the O is. What the, this is a suffix. So when you're ending with a vowel suffix. Huh?
It's
a past tense.
Or
the vowel. Or it's past tense. No, it's going to be cho. So this is the vav here is an o. Cho, o. Okay, so when you have a vowel ending. Okay, so do you remember this one?
It's
and you remember this one.
She.
Y'all fill in the blank. What is he? How do you say he in Hebrew?
Who?
And?
He.
How do you say? Okay,
he.
So who? Is he?
He
is she. Okay? So this right here, a vowel at the end, like that, is going to make it
masculine.
Okay, so suffix here is going to be
masculine.
Okay? So now, and place before them parable another, and say, Kingdom, heaven, similar, grain of mustard, which did to take he, or he took. Okay?
Okay, he took. So let's take this off. Because the lamed there is of or to. It's going to be past tense. Took.
So it's the asher that tells him he already did. Bashar.
The asher here is asher. Which, more which, but it has action too. So why, that's why the did. It's, these are the kind of little things that are a little difficult to, where the grammar of Hebrew differs somewhat from the English. It's not exactly different, but so this would be which, but it has the which did, it has the idea of action taking place to it, which, so you could say which happened.
Well, which we established back when we were saying, because you already said the root is said, and so now we had to establish saying, so then therefore it all had to connect together.
Right.
It all had to be the same, just like in Spanish.
Well, yeah, and we'll see here, you have another, which to our ears is going to sound peculiar. Why do you have the preposition to or of here? Well, because that's the way they do it in Hebrew. That's the answer. Alright? So, you want me to give you a scientific explanation? No, I don't have it. All I can say is, well, that's the way it's done in Hebrew. Okay? So you could say, of which he took, and so, you know, you kind of flip things around a little bit like that, but that's, you know, it's just the way that, which is why I want you to get used to hearing it in the English the way it's coming off in the Hebrew. Because in our English ears, as you're reading it in English, it sounds choppy to you. It sounds cut up to you. Because we're not used to, we're used to us, this is not smooth English. Okay?
That's how they talk online.
If they spell it correct. Here we go, ready? And place before and parable another. And say, kingdom, heaven, silver, grain of mustard, which did
he took.
Okay, yeah. And this, I guess we could probably, I don't know, leave it off in English, I don't know. Okay, so Hebrew. Vayasem livnehem mashal akher vayomar mafu hashamayim domar Legadar Sher Chabar Asher
Lechachor.
So let's go here. Legadar Sher Chabar Asher Lechachor. Okay, do it again. Vayaser Lifnehem Mashar Acher Vayomar Malchut Hashemayim Doma Legadar Sher Chardal Asher Lekacho. Okay, we're going to slow down with these dudes. Here we go, right? Vayasem Livnehem Mashar Acher Vayoma Malchut Hashemayim Doma Legadar Sher Chadad Asher Lechachor. This is an old word.
Ish.
And ish means man.
What?
Ish v'isha. Man and woman.
As again, one is.
Okay, ready? And place before and parable another. And say, kingdom, heaven, similar, grain of mustard, which did he took man. Okay, you see how words are flopping to places where they do not usually occur in English. Okay, that's what I want you to get used to hearing. Again, and place before them parable another, and say, kingdom, heaven, silver, grain of mustard, which did he took man. All right, Hebrew.
Vayaser lifnehem mashal acher. Vayomar malchut hashamayim doma ledargar shel chardal asher lechacho ish.
Again.
Vayaser lifnehem mashal acher. Vayomar malchut השמיים דומה לגרגר של חרגר אשר לקחו איש.
Again.
ויעשר לפניהם משל אחר ויאמר מלכות השמיים דומה לגרגר של חרגר אשר לקחו איש.
Alright. So I'm going to take this down because you already have this. It's in the way. And it's confusing for you. Remember that this at the end means what? Okay. It's like a period. Okay. Anyone have it? Sound it out. Ba Yisra. Okay, the Ayin is silent. Ba Yisra. Ba Yisra. Ba Yisra. So, what is Ba Yisra? Ba is.
Is that seed?
Very good. It's the root of the seed. Okay. So you would say seeded, or how else would you put it?
Planted.
So and planted. Okay. So now let's read it. Can everybody say this? Vayasra, everyone. Vayasra, say it. Vayasra, say it. Vayasra, say it. Vayasra, and plant it. Okay, so here we go, English. And place before them parable another, and say,
kingdom of
heaven, similar grain of mustard, which did he took man and planted. Okay, now is it starting to make sense to you?
Not really. There's some
question
on
Vayisra.
Vayisra.
Vayisra. So the Y and the I that connect together?
Yes.
Okay.
Vayisra. No. If you notice, I don't know if you can see it here. Okay, it's got a dagesh in it, so that's telling you what?
Oh, it has a dagesh in it.
So it's telling you that it is acting as a consonant to this vowel.
Okay.
Ba yi, and so it's ba yi. So this vowel here is connecting to the zayin, okay, which cuts off, right? So ba yis, ba yisa. So this is one syllable here, and then this is another syllable.
Yeah, I didn't see the little.
Oh, okay. So yeah, Vayisra. Everybody got it?
Yes. Can you put it in your Hebrew?
Excuse me?
Can you write it in your Hebrew? Can you write it in
Hebrew? Okay. Okay, everybody, here we go. Ready? And place before them parable another, and say, kingdom of heaven, similar grain of mustard, which did he took man and planted. Now, is this making sense to you? What's the story here? So, what and planted? Who did? Man. He took, what did he take?
The mustard.
The grain of mustard.
Okay, now is it making sense to you? It's not difficult. It's just the words are kind of backwards to us. All right, here we go. Ready? And place before them parable another, as saying, kingdom of heaven similar, grain of mustard, which did he took man and planted. Now, man here, there's no definite article, so what?
Amen.
Understood.
Amen.
Hebrew. Vayasem livdehem mashar ache vayomar mafu hashamahim doma legadar shel chardal asher lekacho ish vayisra. Emphasis on the end. Again. Vayasem livdehem mashar acher vayomar mafut hashamayim doma lekadar shel chardal asher lekacho ish vayisra. Last one. Okay, this one you've already had as well. Ben sadehu. Besadehu. Good. So what? The root is field. And you have a prefix and a suffix.
So it's in and field and him. Or
very good. In field his. Now, understand this, okay? Because in the Torah scroll, in original Hebrew, remember, they don't have all these vowel markings. Yeah. So when you see the vav, when you see the vav here, okay, it's not going to have this, and it's not going to have this. It's just going to be a vav. And it's interchangeable. You have to figure out, is it this vav or is it this vav? And you have to figure that out by the context, and that's why I'm telling you. When you see this at the end as a suffix, this is telling you it's masculine in nature. Whether it's the ovav or whether it's the uvav. In biblical Hebrew, avav is avav. Okay? Now I can still have the vav sound, the v sound, the u sound, or the o sound. But as a prefix, I mean as a suffix, it's still telling you what? Come on, I just told you. It's still telling
it's
you
still
what?
Vav.
It's masculine in nature. Okay, if it comes as a suffix, if it comes as a prefix, it's the connector. And but if it's coming at the end, it's taking on this nature here, which is masculine. So that's why here he, and that's why here his. So in his field. Okay? Ready? And place before them parable another, and saying, kingdom heaven similar, grain of mustard, which did he took a man and planted in field his. In field his. Again, and place before them parable another, and saying, kingdom heaven similar, grain of mustard, which did he took man and planted in field his. Okay? Hebrew.
Vayasem.
Good. Lidnehem mashal acher vayomar mahut hashamahim domah legadar shel chardal asher lekacho ish va yisra besadehu.
Besadehu.
Okay, so the emphasis here on this one is going to go here. Besadehu. Again. Va yaser livnehem mashar acher va yomar
מלכות השמיים דומה לדרגה של חרב אשר לחכון איש במשרה בשדהו.
כן.
ויעשה לפניהם משל אחר. ויאמר מלכות השמיים דומה לדרגה של חרב אשר לכחול איש ויישא בשדהו.
So let's go here.
לכחול איש ויישא בשדהו.
Again.
לכחול איש ויישא בשדהו.
Again.
לכחול איש ויישא בשדהו.
Okay. So this is Matthew 13:31. Matthew 13:31,
which says,
and place before them another parable, and say, kingdom of heaven is similar to a grain of mustard, to which did he took a man and planted in his field. Or he put another parable, he placed before them another parable, saying, the kingdom of heaven is like a grain of mustard seed, a grain of mustard that a man took and planted, seeded. That's why the root word there is what? Sarah, which means seed, right? So he seeded his field, in his field. He planted it in his field. Okay? Everybody got it? Mm-hmm. Fine.